just take me to places I've never known.
What's your name?
Nigel Griffin.
How old are you?
I am 24 years old.
What are you doing nowadays?
Right now, I attend the illustrious North Carolina Central University.
How's that going?
It's going great. It's one of the greatest experiences I've ever experienced.
So this whole concept is talking to a younger or older version of yourself. So which one are you choosing to talk to?
I'm actually going to flow, and I'm going to start with my younger self. And then I'm going to go into that with a couple comments from my older self.
So what are you saying to the younger Nigel Griffin?
All right. First thing I want to start off is, like, to the young me, take appreciation in the struggle. Because it's like a understanding of being humble. You get to see different perspectives. You get to see inspiration from it. You also be able to have an appreciation for everything that you get, for everything that you have, and all the people that's like helped you when you was down, or even while you was up. Because I remember like at a time of, like, when I was like real young, both my parents was doing like very well. I was like 5 or 6. To watch my dad like lose his job, and then my mom lose like going from making $100,000 a year to making paycheck to paycheck for whatever that she can do. I had to grow up not even being able to afford oodles and noodles at one point in time. I want to tell my younger self to appreciate those times, because it showed me that I was able to endure. It showed me that I had a strong spirit. It showed me that I was able to, even though I was going through something, I knew that I was strong enough to be able to help others, even though I was going through a lot for myself. And when I was able to struggle, I saw who my true friends were. When I didn't have nothing, I was able to see the people who was there for me, who even went out their way to ask me to be a part of things, even when I didn't have no bread and put in for it. So I want to tell you, be thankful for your friends that you have. Be thankful for all those people. Be thankful for your day ones. Be thankful for the ones you grow up with, because those are the people that's always going to be there for you. When you're thankful for like your struggles, I was able to get to see like the real people around you. I was able to see like how to like really read people too. Like when I was up and I saw everybody that was my friend, I saw everybody that was good for me. I saw all that when I was up, I was doing great. Everybody was there for me. And then when I started to have my downfalls in certain times, everybody was gone. I was like at that point in my time as well, I did feel a little lonely. And it's not because I didn't know that I had people to love me and stuff like that. It's like I felt like I had to be stronger for like everybody else. So like young Nigel, take appreciation of the struggle. Take everything into account, take everything that you felt, because you wouldn't be who you are today. You will be thankful for who you are now. And all the lessons that you took from the past, just appreciate that. And also, like, when you're lacking things, you're forced to be creative. You're forced to put yourself in uncomfortable situations. And when you put yourself in uncomfortable situations, you will grow. And I learned a lot about myself. When I was forced to put myself in uncomfortable situations, be okay. Like, times when I wasn't able to even wash my clothes in the washing machine, me and my mom used to sit in the bathtub, get some laundry detergent, and be in the bathtub, like, rubbing all the clothes, getting all the dirt, all the gunk out. Shoot. That was a struggle. Hanging the clothes up around the house, you know, and just, you know, watching my mother like, struggle. That Use that to inspire you. Don't use that to like let you put yourself down. Don't let like negative distractions or anything like that. And also, like when you learn to appreciate everything, like moving on up. When I finally got to high school, I said, when you set goals for myself, also be okay with failure. failure is probably the best thing that's ever happened to you. Appreciate all that, because when you're always successful, you never truly learn. You know, you should never truly get better. You never truly appreciate things because you always expect. You always expect things to go your way. Be okay with failure. Don't just accept it, though. Don't just turn your L's into your lessons. Make yourself better at the end of the day, always. And also, take the time to go out your way for the people that you care for. Like, show them how appreciative you was, because I do know that sometimes you was really sick, like, it was really like, how would I explain it? Stubborn. When sometimes things wasn't going your way and things did get hard. So understand, like, there are people around you to talk to you and feel like, to like understand the pain that you're going through. Even if you feel like they wasn't helping you, the fact that they tried was very important. Just be strong in that. Be strong in that aspect. Appreciate. Dang, I guess I'm getting messed up. When I was in high school, going through all the struggles that she was going through, watching your parents like argue and stuff like that, even seeing your sister depressed and stuff like that, you want to be there for everybody. I also want to take the time to, that you should, even though you may not talk to this person a lot anymore, appreciate that one person that like was always there for you. And then you used her, not used her, but like, she was like your rock to hold you down and stuff like that. Even though y'all not cool no more and stuff like that, and like, appreciate the times that you give, because that was some real love right there that you had. And truly appreciate it and all that, and all things. Because like, honestly, without her, I don't know how I really feel. Felt like that. I don't know where I'd really be. That was my stress reliever. But going to college was great. You don't acknowledge it. You still was doing good. You made some achievements, but you did have some downfalls. And like I said, I always appreciate those. I will hold myself accountable to all things today. If I'm gonna say something to my older self now, when you come back and watch this video. When you come back and watch this video, remember, just always stay true to your dreams, your ambitions. And I also want to say, you did good, bro. You did good, because I'm gonna make myself happen. I'm gonna make all my dreams happen. And to my younger self, I only really said this because when I'm watching this with my little ones, when I'm older, this is really for them. I want them to be okay with failure. I want them. This is all really for y'all. I can't regret nothing that I have. I've learned from everything. I just want y'all to be better than me.
Yeah. Okay. Alayah.
How old are you?
24.
What are you doing nowadays?
I got two jobs. I am a retail manager at American Eagle, and I am a intern in the psych ward at Brent's Hospital.
So this whole concept is choosing to talk to a younger or older version of yourself. Which one are you choosing to talk to?
I'm gonna talk to the younger version of myself.
What are you saying to the younger Alayah Lee?
I would say to my younger self, I don't really have regrets, too many regrets in life, but I would just tell my younger self to not give up. And it is not, what you're going through is not gonna last forever, even though it may feel as though there's no light at the end of the tunnel or any greater things coming, there will be. There's a reason why you are going through the things that you are going through right now. If I go back to like college time, younger self is like 3 years back, not even like very young. I feel like growing up, life was really easy for me. I didn't really have too many hard times, too many struggles. A lot of people around me struggled, but I didn't really know that for myself. It wasn't until I got to college and kind of got on my own and started like living my, kind of my own life that I feel like things took a sour point. Like growing up in high school, I think I was like the friend of guys. I never really had a boyfriend. I was just like that one cool friend, honestly, to be honest. You know, being a daddy's girl, like I knew what there was to know about sports. I knew about cars. I knew about like all things guys talked about. All of my closest friends I grew up with were guys, but I was never like the girl that guys went after. I was just their friend. So I got to college and interest started being shown. I didn't know how to act. You know, I was taking everything every which way. And I think I was so pressed to be in a relationship. I don't know why. And I feel like sometimes when you go looking for things, that gives, honestly, the devil ways to throw obstacles in your way. I got in a relationship that I shouldn't have been in, honestly, but I don't regret it, where it was really just abuse from every angle, mentally, verbally, emotionally. It became physically and sexually towards the end of the relationship. And it was just not a good thing. And it was honestly the worst time of my life. To be honest, I kind of fell into, I say the word abyss, like just of nothingness after going through that relationship. And even after, you know, I got beaten almost to the point of no return, I was still mentally in that relationship. So I was still going back, dealing with this person. It took me a while to get out of what I felt like was a cycle, just because like it's what I had gotten used to for so long. And I just felt like I'm never gonna get out of this. This is the end all be all for me. You know, like this is it. Once I finally got out of that relationship, my whole life just took a turn. Started failing grades. My grades were failing. My relationships with people were dwindling. Like it was a very small amount of people that I still had by my side. And not because they didn't want to be, I just didn't allow them to be there for me, I think. It was just a place I never envisioned myself being in growing up the way I did, seeing the kind of relationship that my parents had. Like, that's what I always wanted. And I still don't know why. Like, what I had was the total opposite of what my parents were and what I said I wanted in life. But it was very, I learned a lot. And I think that going through all of that really, at the time, it felt like, you know, it felt horrible. Like I lost 30 pounds. My grandma thought I was a crack. I went to see a therapist, which is really what got me into what my job is now. But that's, you know, I'll get back to that. Coping, all I did was run. And I think that was a psychological way of me trying to run away the situation that I was in. But it took an unhealthy turn because I was running, but I wasn't eating. Like I was in a very like hard stage of depression. I wasn't eating. I wasn't talking to anybody. Literally I ran in the morning at 6 a.m. I ran during lunch and I ran at night with my dog. Like that's what I did every day. Probably ate like one meal a day. I lost 30 pounds and it wasn't a good 30 pounds. It was very unhealthy. Like I look back at pictures now where I literally had like, you could see my ribs, which is freaking crazy.
this is what this is for. I'm gonna put this on there.
Okay. Okay. It's fine. My depression got so bad that being raised in a household where I went to church every Sunday, every Tuesday, every Thursday, every Saturday, I was so upset with God, to be honest. And I lost my entire faith. I didn't want to go to church. I didn't want to talk about church. I didn't want to do anything. So I didn't understand how, if I followed every single rule that he had and I was living the way I was supposed to be living, and I wasn't perfect, like I'm not a saint. I didn't understand why he would allow me to be physically abused and almost raped pretty much when I followed all his instructions. So I took a break I lost myself. I went out, I was drinking all the time. I was partaking in other activities. It was just a really tough time. And once, after going to my therapist, my mom made me go. And I didn't, it's crazy because being that I was a psychology major, I really wasn't as deep. I was just honestly going to college because my parents told me to. I said, oh, psychology seems cool. Like, I like the way the brain works. It wasn't a huge, like, this is what I wanted to do. But going to the therapist really put everything into perspective for me. And not only did it help me cope, but it also fueled a fire within me to stay in the path that I'm doing and to help someone the way that I'm being helped in this moment. So while all that was dark and all that was just a mess, I'm very thankful for it because I feel like to be someone that helps someone, you have to understand the things that people go through. You have to have dealt with certain things because I feel like you cannot give advice or lead someone a certain way when you've never done it yourself. Like, I'm not gonna sit and talk to a therapist about me being abused and almost raped and she, like, this has never happened to her. How can you help me with something that you haven't dealt with? So to be able to really be able to connect with someone on that level is very important. So I'm thankful. I'm thankful for everything that I went through. And I would just tell my younger self, like, it is okay. It may not seem like it is okay right now, but I promise you, this situation will lead you somewhere. This situation is giving you your purpose. This situation was needed. Because like I said, I never really went through anything as a child or even like middle school, high school. I had to be able to go through something to get to something. And where I'm at now is exactly where I feel like I'm supposed to be. So I don't regret a piece of it. Like, what is happening right now, I promise you, it will get better. And you will look back on this situation and be in the place where I am now to know that it had to happen for you to be able to do the things and be where you are at in this moment right now. And that's...
What's up, guys? Thank you for watching this past video. If you're willing to watch it this far, so you obviously know what's been going on, what's happening. If you or someone you know is going through something regarding domestic violence, please call the number below. It's nothing to play with. It's very serious. Yeah, so call the number below. Only thing I can do is give you the number. Reach out. Ask for help. Don't be afraid. It's okay. Everything will be okay. Thank you.